What inspires change? What motivates us? It's what's inside that moves us. What moves you? Get the Scion story at Scion.com.
Citizens of the Freely Associated States, the Republic of the Marshall Islands, and the Republic of Palau, who have entered Guam via the Compact's provisions, are subject to deportation if convicted of a felony or a crime of moral turpitude. They are subject to deportation if they are sentenced to 1 year or more for any crime committed in Guam, or if they are repeated offenders of the driving under the influence alcohol statutes.
Senator Roy Rispisciò held a roundtable discussion on the deportation of criminals from the Freely Associated States who are here on Guam as a result of the Compacts of Free Association. The Freely Associated States include the FSM, the Republic of the Marshall Islands, and the Republic of Palau. The governor's chief policy advisor, Arthur Clark, says that Guam's laws may have to be amended to allow immigration to deport FAS citizens convicted of aggravated assaults.
Aggravated assault, which we read about all the time, or you know what a lot of these convictions end up becoming, is actually a crime of recklessness. So on that basis, I was advised by ICE that the statute itself, if it was amended, would then give them the ability to deport.
Clark says that crimes of intent is what they look at when trying to determine if something is a crime of moral turpitude. Thus, Clark recommends changing Guam laws to ensure that aggravated assaults are considered crimes of intent and therefore crimes of moral turpitude. However, Chief Deputy Attorney General Phil Tidinko explained that it's difficult to classify many of these aggravated assaults as crimes of intent or moral turpitude because many of them happen under the influence of alcohol and are easier to prove as crimes of recklessness rather than intent.
I would tell you, many of the alcohol-based crimes, it's difficult to charge the intent mens rea. So we'll probably have a lot of defense motions saying dismiss it and we lose those cases because clearly under the circumstances where they're alcohol is involved, it'd be difficult with a specific intent. That would be a defense that's built in. If you look at the vast majority of these crimes, alcohol is a base and recklessness is a good mens rea to charge for those circumstances as opposed to intentional and knowing.
Also, Vice Speaker B.J. Cruz pointed out that there may already be deportable prisoners who simply have not been deported yet.
Before we sit around, and I have no objection to amending the law, that's simple. But first we have to get back to, I think, what the first thing that Mr. Clark mentioned. The sincerity of the United States to do anything, or whether it's budgetary constraints that's doing this. So we can amend all the laws that we want. We need to know whether or not they're sincere about doing any deportation. And the way to check that is right now is to get the list of those that are currently incarcerated, that are deportable, and why haven't they been deported?
However, Clark believes that money is not necessarily the issue, but there may be issues of manpower to determine which criminals are eligible for deportation, and he says there is likely issues with the definition of certain crimes as crimes of moral turpitude. Meanwhile, Tidinko also cautioned against singling out compact migrants in any legislation dealing with deportation, and he recommended including all non-U.S. citizens.
This is not done in any way on my part or any of our part to try to get the community going that this is a terrible group of individuals who don't have to be here at all. I've said on the record over and over that we welcome them and we appreciate that they're filling a niche in our community that's required. Those blue collar workers, and some of them are professionals. And I've also said for the record that crime does not discriminate, whether it's the criminal or the victim. All races commit crime. And so our focus here today, ladies and gentlemen, is just on what can we do to honor the tenets of the Compact Impact.